The University of Hertfordshire is a pretty big institution, about 27,000 students, and we're based just 20 minutes north of London from King's Cross.
We're very proud of the Games Art course at the University of Hertfordshire. The Games Art course has become one of the most important degrees in the UK in the games industry. The course as a whole has won the best Games Art course in the world twice now at the Rookies Awards. The students have won Game of the Year. We've won that three times now. Our students have been shortlisted in over 140 different animation festivals worldwide.
At first, I got accepted into every other university I applied for except this one. But this was the one that I was really looking to go to because the work they were putting out, it was really high.
All of our students, when they join the course, regardless of the 4 degrees they're on, they do what we call a common first year.
Cross-disciplinarity gives them the opportunity to go beyond the thing they thought they wanted to study, and it means that they can explore areas that they wouldn't have even thought of doing.
It's a really good way of making sure you know all the basics of basically everything art-based, and also just letting you have a go at everything. So we'll do like technical things, much more arty things, just in case you didn't know you liked it.
One of the great things about Unreal Engine is it's got started as a game engine, whereas I'd probably describe it now as more of a reality engine. It's like a giant sandbox where you can experiment with anything. It's accessible to people who maybe signed up to an arts course and didn't realise they were going to have to learn some programming. They come to the first Blueprints lesson and they go, but I'm not a programmer, I'm terrified of this. And then you explain that you just plug the wires in and you can experiment. And if you get it wrong, it just tells you where you got it wrong.
I think what I love about Unreal Engine 4 is the fact that the students can really choose their discipline, what is it they want to do in life.
Because it's not just designed for games. I mean, obviously it's brilliant at that, but where it excels as well is the fact it can be customised into pretty much anything you want.
That gives that kind of seed in the student's mind of that I can use this for something else.
There's this whole vast other area of stuff which requires real-time visualisation. And, you know, most courses aren't really catering to that.
We've got students all around the world now, at Nintendo, we've got students on Fortnite, Bentley, visualising at McLaren.
We have graduates doing real-time architectural visualisation at places like Foster and Partners. We also find that the visual effects industry and cartoon animation, they're now hiring our students with Unreal skills.
Some people just make stuff on the marketplace and they're doing better than me. The thing we're most proud of at the university is the level of fidelity and quality in the students' work. They really strive to be the best, to try and make their product to look stand up against AAA titles as much as they can. And the Unreal Engine really allows that, just because it's the same tool that they're using at these really high-end companies.
We know one thing we can guarantee is the future is going to become more interactive, if it isn't already. It is going to be 3D, and it will be made in Unreal.